watching animation of a special kind, made by artists who use not a brush and paint, but a computer. This is work in progress for a client who wanted to create a unique fantasy world to advertise a very traditional product. It reflects a new generation of synthetic imagery which has come of age. It is the shape of things to come. Hello, I'm Bob Abel, and what you've just seen is the most recent computer imagery from Abel Image Research. But it's just the latest in a long tradition of innovation that we started many years ago. You see, we knew that computer imagery not only grabbed people's attention, but was incredibly cost-effective, and it worked well in combination with traditional live action. Several years ago, we were able to save Chevrolet $50,000 on their Corvette commercial because we could build this tunnel using computer graphics. We could even show all the reflections on the car while it raced through the tunnel, and that made the environment look real. As you may recall, that spot won a lot of awards, but most importantly, it sold the car. Creating computer images is actually a lot of fun for both us and our clients. Thankfully, it's a lot easier than some of that mumbo-jumbo jargon can sometimes make it sound. I'd like to get past the mystique and show you actually how we go about making computer images. First, you need to describe your product to the computer, and the method is pretty much up to you. You can use blueprints, or pictures, or even three-dimensional models like this eagle's head. These options are making the process increasingly convenient for everyone to use. You can also create realistic pictures from scratch. Take the natural shape of a rock, for example. To make this image, we start with a simple shape and keep building it up with polygons until it appears three-dimensional. Then we add a skin on which we can put a marbleized surface. What Kenny Merman is doing here is scanning a marble pattern into the computer. Then he can enhance it, literally paint in the pattern, using an electronic palette and pointer to choose his colors. This image, blown up 40 times, is actually what the client can see in real time as Kenny enhances the picture. The computer then wraps the finished texture around the rock, and it's ready to move through a scene. Using simple techniques, we were able to create an award-winning corporate campaign for TRW. Let's take a look.
First, someone gets an idea. Then someone else may look at it differently, even add a thought or two. Technology from a company called TRW helps ideas get around. Because getting an idea from one place to another is as important as getting an idea. Did you ever notice that just when you think you see the whole picture, the picture changes? Technology from a company called TRW lets us look at our world in fresh ways. Because there's more to everything than meets the eye. You have to draw the line someplace. Then, cross over it. That's how new ideas start. How new worlds open up. Technology from a company called TRW helps chart new worlds. Today, we draw the line where it has never been before. Tomorrow, we'll cross over it. Tomorrow is taking shape at a company called TRW.
Now, TRW was selling abstract ideas. Most of our clients, like Chevy Corvette, need to show a tangible product in a unique environment. For Hoover Vacuum, we created an appealing, attention-getting spot with simple but realistic-looking objects. A simple shape starts out looking like something from Sesame Street. Then, right in front of you on a monitor, you can see it take on dimension when a light source is added to the picture. As you add highlights, the objects begin to look real. Put them in an environment, and the computer has the information on where the reflections should appear. With each step, the sense of reality increases. And here's how it appears in the finished commercial.
You're about to enter the next dimension in cleaning systems from Hoover. With Hoover Cleaning Action.
Dimension.
With electronic control on the handle.
Dimension.
with hidden tools.
Dimension.
Up to 4.3 peak horsepower, adjusting by itself electronic.
Dimension.
Enter the Hoover Dimension cleaning system.
The next dimension. Dimension. Dimension.
Another reason why America trusts Hoover.
That spa tested so well, it is now the look of Hoover's entire campaign. And the system that created it is so flexible that it allows decisions to be made right before the eyes of the agency and the client. Take the process of selecting colors. We can make up a table which can have between 6,000 and 16 million colors. And when you say, "I want that pink," we convey that number to the computer. Using our little friend Ava here as a model, we can change colors on screen as fast as you're seeing here. Now that you've met Ava, let's take a moment to look at her in a modern-day cartoon called High Fidelity, which we originally made to test our computer tools. No matter how simple or complex your object may be, we use the same principles of lighting that we use on a live-action set. Take this elk, for example. We start with a wireframe model and fill it in with white light. Then we put it through various levels of shading and smoothing and add the front light, back light, hard light, and soft light that we'd use on a live-action stage. Before you know it, there's a fully lit, three-dimensional object. Now we can give it a skin by taking information stored in the computer and wrapping it around the object. And what makes our system extra special is that we can animate that texture with the object when it moves. Watch the neck of the elk as he turns his head. And here's how it looks in the context of the full commercial. Obviously, our computer animation is not limited to simple motion. In 1984, we developed ways to simulate realistic human motion. And our first test became Clio's grand prize winner, the sexy robot.
Even in the year 3000, the question will be, what's for dinner? The answer will be in a package that saves energy, nutrients, and trouble. A package that can last the 3-year journey to Jupiter and back and back and back. Even in the year 3000, we see the brilliance of food in cans.
We wanted this robot to have all the elegance of a real woman. Human movements work in a hierarchy, and the way a torso moves determines how the limbs move. A technique to capture this kind of hierarchical motion was created by director Randy Roberts. He started by filming a live model. The computer tracked the reference points painted on her body and created a stick figure we call a vector graphic. The sexy robot opened up a whole series of opportunities for commercials that required human-like motion. Let's take a look at another example.
The telephone has evolved into the Vodafone. Vodafones have been seen on the roads, on lakes and rivers, even in the middle of nowhere. And they can communicate with ordinary telephones as well as other Vodafones.
Can you come out tonight?
I'm afraid I'm tied up.
As more Vodafones appear, we can only wonder whether the telephone is an endangered species. If you'd like to be in when you're out, get on the Vodafone.
However sophisticated these images may seem, they start with basics, good creative thought expressed in storyboards like these, just like the ones you use every day. When Steven Spielberg brought us his storyboards for Amazing Stories, he had 37 objects designed to fly by in 45 seconds. He wanted to create an opening for Amazing Stories that people would watch over and over again. And he believed that computer animation had that power. Animation like this has images that people watch and remember. Each of you has a different message, and we believe that computer animation is the best way to grab people's attention and hold it. The only limit is your imagination. At Abel Image Research, we're dedicated to making images that people watch and remember. To update an old saying, one picture may be worth 1,000 words, but if you can make it move, it's worth 1,000,000.